This episode is brought to you by Skillfeed. Skillfeed's online training has close to 26,000 HD video tutorials with downloaded project files totaling 3,000 hours of learning by vetted instructors. Whether it's Photoshop, web development, 3D software, photography, or motion graphics, Skillfeed helps you learn it. Get a full month of membership with no obligation when you go to skillfeed.com/bluelightningtv2014. After that, if you decide to continue membership, it's less than $20 a month. Go to the link below and start your free month of membership. Learn what you want and learn what you love. Thanks, Skillfeed, for supporting Blue Lightning TV. Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you a simple, effective way to lose weight and sculpt a body in a photograph using the Liquify filter in Photoshop. This filter is available in versions CS6 and later. Open a photo of a person you'd like to reshape. Make a copy of the layer by pressing Ctrl-J on Windows or Command-J on a Mac. I found that the best way to reshape a figure is to first separate it from its background so the background doesn't get distorted when we're reshaping the figure. To cut and copy the figure from its background, we need to make a selection surrounding it. There are many ways to make selections, so use the method that's the easiest and most effective for you. For this example, I'll use the pencil tool. If you're using this method too, choose a small pixel size and keep the hardness at 100%. Press Enter or Return and press the F5 key at the top of your keyboard. This opens the brush panel. Click the icon at the upper right corner of the panel and click Reset All Locked Settings. This basically brings your brush back to its default settings. Then press F5 again to close the panel. If your foreground and background colors aren't black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. Click the Quick Mask icon so your pencil lines will be a quick mask. Press Z to open your zoom tool and drag over an area to zoom into it. Press B to open your pencil tool. Draw over the inside edge of the figure. Take as much time as you need. To move the image on your screen, hold the space bar as you drag the image. Once you've made an outline around the figure and pressed Ctrl or Command 0 to fit the entire document on your screen, open your Paint Bucket tool and click inside the figure. If your entire document fills in, it means your outline does have at least one hole. So, you need to zoom into your outlines, inspect them carefully, and fill in the holes. Press Q again to make the quick mask back into a selection, and then invert the selection by pressing Ctrl or Command-Shift-I. Now that we have a selection of the shape of the figure, press Ctrl or Command-J to cut it out from its background and copy it to its own layer. Ctrl-click or Command-click on the figure to see the selection of its shape again. Click on the thumbnail of layer 1 to make the layer active, and click off the eyeball of layer 2 to temporarily hide it. Go to Select, Modify, and Expand. We'll expand it by 10 pixels. Depending on the size and resolution of your image, you may want to adjust this amount so your selection has expanded away from your figure as much as in this example. Go to Edit and Fill. Choose Content Aware and click OK. Content Aware analyzes the contents of the image that's inside the selection and tries its best to show you what the photo would have looked like if the figure had never been there. It's not perfect, but it doesn't have to be, since we're going to place the figure on top of the filled-in background. Delete the selection by pressing Ctrl or Command-D. Make your figure visible and active. Go to Filter and Liquify. Click Advanced Mode. I'll show you a quick way you can adjust the brush size on the fly. For this example, we'll keep the brush density at 50, the brush pressure at 100, and the rate at 0. Make sure Show Backdrop is checked and use Layer 1 as the backdrop. Layer 1 is the filled-in background. The mode is behind since we want the backdrop to be behind the figure. To achieve the effects we want, we're only going to use a few of these icons. We'll start with the Pucker tool. To make your brush smaller or larger, press the left or right bracket key. Make your brush a bit larger than the area you want to pucker. I find that gently tapping on various areas works better than holding down your mouse or pen. This tool moves pixels towards the center of the brush, making your image look puckered or sucked in. Don't be concerned if it's distorting areas of your image that you don't want distorted, like the hands in this example. I'll show you how to restore those areas later. The Bloat tool does just the opposite of the Pucker tool by moving pixels away from the center, making areas look larger and more rounded. The Push Left tool pushes pixels to the right as you drag the tool down and pushes pixels to the left as you hold down Alt or Option as you drag the tool down. If you have an area near the edge that got distorted with the Push Left tool, use your Forward Warp tool to push pixels forward as you drag your brush. Let's say I use my Push Left tool to thin this arm and don't like the results. I'll show you what to do if you make a mistake and want to restore that area to its original state. I'll open my Reconstruct tool, change the density to 100, and brush over the arm to restore it to its original state. I think I'd like to make the waist a little thinner, so I'll change back the density to 50, open my Pucker tool, make my brush a little bigger than the waist, and tap on it. When you're happy with your figure, click OK. As I toggle back and forth, you can see the difference. To correct areas that you didn't want distorted, we'll use a layer mask to restore them. First, make a composite snapshot of your image by pressing Ctrl-Shift-Alt-E on Windows or Command-Shift-Option-E on a Mac. Hide the two middle layers and click the layer mask icon to make a layer mask next to the composite snapshot. Open your brush tool, make the size relatively small to medium, and brush over the areas that you want to restore to its original state. What we're actually doing is hiding areas of the retouched image so they reveal the original unretouched image below it in the Layers panel. If you have areas of the original image showing through, you'll want to retouch them out. First, make a composite snapshot of your entire image. For this example, I'll use the Clone Stamp tool to retouch them out. Using these techniques, you can shed pounds and reshape a figure quickly and painlessly. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.